Hello! Today we're going to look at the Circuit Playground Express and how to use the light sensors. The light sensor is up here in the corner with this little eye, and there are a few things we can do. We can set a threshold for the light sensor, we can analog read the value of the light, or we can trigger different events for the light. On start, what we want to do is set our threshold, and we can either choose what our threshold is for a dark value or a bright value. And when we cross this threshold, it considers it either a dark or a light. So over here, I trigger events, and when it crosses this threshold and becomes in the bright side, then it's going to play a power-up sound. And when it crosses the threshold to what it considers to be the dark side, it's going to play a power-down sound. And each of these events are triggered whenever they happen, and then it goes through the checklist of steps, which we only have one in here. And then in this forever loop, this is what it's constantly doing. It's constantly reading the analog input from the light sensor and graphing it using the neopixels. So let's change this a little bit. As we decrease the light, you can see the graph of the sensors goes down. And it won't play for me on here, and you can't hear it with my headphones anyway. But when it crosses over this 160 threshold, that's when it's going to play the power up. And then when I go back down this way, that's when it would play the power down. We can also read the ambient light color, and it's different from the light level. Let's look first at what the light level graph looks like when we go to our simulator, and it's going to be, if we adjust this, we can see it's a value between 255 and 0 as we're going up and down through our light sensor. But if we go back and instead pick ambient light, it's looking at the RGB values that we have. And it's going to take each of them, which have 256 values, and it's going to create a rather large number right here. This is our maximum number that we can have. So as we're changing these, it's looking at the RGB values, and that's why this range is a lot larger. Let's look at the JavaScript for this. There are a lot of comments in this. Let's look at the ones that aren't in this forest green color. So in the beginning, our first event we're going to do is we're going to set the threshold, and we're saying our condition is dark. If you pick the other one, this would say dot bright, and this is the value that we wanted to set. This is our forever function, so this is the loop that we're going to continuously go through, and we're going to graph our light using ambient color. And up here are the events that we can trigger. So upon input of the light condition changing to bright, we're going to play this sound. And upon the condition that it changes to dark, we're going to play the power down sound. And that's all the JavaScript does. So let's look at a demonstration of how this would work.